Hey everyone, are you wondering what the dehaze does in Lightroom? Well, today I'm going to go over that in this simple quick tutorial, kind of breaking it down and giving sense of it. So we got this nice portrait. Now, most of the time you're going to use this on landscape when it's hazy. However, there are some other uses for it that I personally use on a frequent basis. So what I'm going to do is I've already got the dehaze used in this photo. However, we're going to go and reset it real quick. So as you can see, you know, if we look at the histogram is very, very useful. Now, don't get scared. It's kind of confusing, but basically the left-hand side is the dark side and the right-hand side is the whites and the highlights and the bright stuff. The bright stuff and the dark stuff. Bright stuff, dark stuff. And it did take me a while to learn that for some reason, but so what we have going on right now is we got a nice photo, and I'll show you the settings real quick just so that you can get an idea. ISO 120 20th of a second, f3.2, ISO 100 on a 50 millimeter f1.8. now this is a pretty soft lens, so I'm actually surprised. I thought that was the 1.4, but 1.8, and so we have a little bit of softness on here, and I think there was a lot of highlights as well on here. So what basically the dehaze does is it's a secondary contrast. It's kind of like a contrast. It brings up, so if we bring this down, you're going to see the histogram goes into the lighter side, and as you can see, we also lose quite a bit of contrast. And why would you want to do this instead of contrast, the actual contrast tool? Well, as you can see, there's a huge difference when we use both these sliders. If we bring the contrast up, this is the contrast. So as you can see, it gets darker. There's more contrast, as you can see. If we bring the dehaze up, you also get a little bit darker, but it's a lot lighter, as you can see. This is a lot different from the contrast. So they're very different. So for this image, I'm gonna go with the same settings, similar settings that I began with. So we're gonna bring this down, and it's all kind of like what your eye does. So as you can see, that's what we have. We have the before, after, negative 47 dehaze. Now, what you can do now is you can actually bring down the exposure of this. So you can bring down the shadows and you bring down the blacks, and you get that same effect, the same exposure, but you have more control. And this is why I love using the dehaze. I use it on sunsets. I use it on different... let's bring this down. This is kind of just like going by eye, but you can use a bunch of other settings, a bunch of these other exposure settings. And this is more of an advanced tool for as far as what you want to do. What the dehaze also does is it also brings down the saturation a little bit. So we're going to pop that back up there a little bit. And as you can see, we get a similar photo. Let's see the difference. Now, I personally like the second one better. Now, there are some problems with the whites that I don't like, and we can bring up the dehaze a little bit to bring back a little bit of that contrast, but you get a different kind of kick, and you can change your settings a lot using dehaze. Now, if you have like a foggy photo, this is really good for bringing out the contrast in that. As far as this photo goes, there was a bit too much contrast because the sun, I believe it was a cloudy day, overcast, and it was just way too bright. So as you can see, we made a better photo of the original photo. And that's kind of just what the dehaze does on a portrait. Now, if you would like to see a landscape photo, don't forget to leave a like. I may do one, but you know, this is kind of just the rundown of what the dehaze tool does. And it's really amazing too, because you can also edit this in a brush as well. But we won't go into that in this video, but don't forget to leave a like if you learned something in this simple quick tutorial. And I will see you guys on the next video. See you guys.